Graham, welcome to the East Area Committee. I know you attended the West Central Area Committee recently as well. I'm led to believe you want to give a presentation and perhaps take some questions following on from that. Is that correct?
Mainly interested in questions. I can do a little presentation because I haven't met you before. I'm delighted to be here.
Thank you.
I'm actually meeting all sorts of interesting people all over the place. Tomorrow night I'm doing one in Peterborough, so one end to the other. I've only been in the role for about 100 days now, and quite a lot has had to happen. First of all, is it switched on?
First of all, I've published the police and crime plan, and that went to the panel last week. That's been on the website for some time now, and it sets out quite clearly what we're trying to achieve. It's worth having a look at it because it covers a huge area. We have to look at not just the cities, but the villages, the rural side of things, rural crime. Specific problems like antisocial behaviour, and it was interesting listening to the sort of comments about cyclists and parking. I mean, I regard people that park on pavement as being antisocial because it's causing pedestrians often to have to walk into the road, which is extremely dangerous, and I'm quite concerned about that. But I've been focusing on the question of burglary and the way that is treated, because I wasn't happy with it in the past. I'm insisting now that if someone has a burglary, the police visit them within a couple of hours and not two or three days later to give you a crime number. Because if we're going to catch burglars, they've got to be there, they've got to inspect it, because our job is to arrest burglars and put them into prison, because then they can't burgle anyone else. So that is a pretty important move we've made. Getting people to get in touch with the police and report problems, report perhaps suspicious movements, was a problem because of the length of time it took for people to get through on the 101. And that was a real problem, and I know because I've tried it several times before. I'm pleased to say now that you can get through on 101 and speak to someone within 30 seconds. And that is a dramatic improvement, because the first time I tried it was nine minutes, 10 seconds. The idea of that is to encourage people to contact the police in that way. And we've also got to ensure that if there is a problem out there, we can get the police to any place within the county, within minutes. And obviously, if it's a 999 call, that is answered instantly, and you usually get quite a few policemen turn up if it's a serious problem. But the idea is to give the public comfort that we're actually doing that. I've spent some time encouraging neighbourhood watch. I know that's not very big in Cambridge, you've only got one real operator here, but there's no reason why you can't join in, because I've commissioned some software that came from the Home Office that's called Alert, and that we hope will come into operation within the next few weeks. And what that does, it shows you on your particular patch what has happened the day before, whether there's been any crime, any burglaries, any problems. It also flags up if the police want you to watch out for things and feedback to them. And that can be done purely by looking at your computer. So anyone who has a computer, and most people nowadays do, you can check that out. And it doesn't mean going to a meeting, or you can do it from home. The good thing about it, having done a bit of trialling in the south of the county, is that we're getting, I think, the best networkers are mums with children. They really are fabulous. And, you know, they can get in and do that because they haven't got to go to a meeting or anything. They can just check it up and talk about it. So make an effort to get people involved. In the coming year, I'm going to have to take over victim support commissioning. So that falls onto my budget, which I hope the government are going to fund me for. I'd be in trouble if they don't. They are intending to do that, but it comes, we do the commissioning. And I think victim support is something that we do have to sort of tidy up the actions on that front. I'm very concerned, particularly if you have an elderly person that's been mugged or burgled. They are so traumatised, they don't know what to do with themselves. If it's a burglary, they just want to go away and leave home. We don't want that to happen, and so we've got to get victim support speedily too. So one of the things I'm doing is sort of trying to marry some of the neighbourhood watch with that, so we can get local people to go there within minutes rather than 4 or 5 days later. I think that's important, that we look after that side of things. Now, my actual title is Police and Crime Commissioner. And I'm wearing the Crime Commissioner's hat now more than I'm the Police Commissioner's hat, because it's all about prevention, trying to stop crime happening. And I'm particularly concerned with young people, because if a young person does offend and get into trouble with the police, they have a black mark for the rest of their lives. Now, though we have an excellent service in Cambridgeshire, the Youth Offending Service, it's too late, it's already happened. So what I'm trying to do is to get more proactive service going on, trying to prevent youngsters getting into trouble, and if you have a particularly difficult family, to get alongside them and to advise and help and stop the youngsters getting into trouble, help that family. And this is something that I'm hoping on the voluntary side we can do even more for. And I'm around talking to business and industry at the moment to see whether we can get some extra support on that front. So that is helping to prevent crime. And there are quite another number of initiatives which we're looking at where we can try and help to prevent crime taking place. The other big thing that we're doing is trying to increase the number of special constables. Special constables have the same power as the ordinary constable. They're volunteers. We had, I think, 235 of them. The target now is to go for 350, and I think we'll get there. I've upped the profile. We're showing lots more support. I've got people like the Lord Lieutenant involved in going to the passing outs to raise their profile. We've got them doing a lot more in Cambridge City. And some of the cycling problems we've had, the specials are taking a lead on that. And I think it's a wonderful thing that they can actually have ownership of something. But obviously we need to look at them right across the county. It's easier in the cities. They're a bit sparse when you come to villages, but nevertheless, I want to see the specials appearing in some of the villages and being seen. And giving them specific jobs. So this is a new feature, not just tagging along, but actually having their own jobs. So lots of things happening, and I could talk all evening about it, but I just sort of skated across a few. But I would urge you to look at the website and see the tremendous amount of thought that's gone into it. And what I did, I decided not to sort of have a revolution, but to have evolution. The previous police authority had got a good crime plan, so we've tuned it up. I've added my pieces into it, we've brought it up to date, and so, you know, you can see sustainability going right the way through it. I didn't want to sort of suddenly come along and throw everything out, start again. It was already there and it was working well. We're just trying to make it work better. And the only other thing I think to finish off by saying is that the big battle, of course, is where do we find the money from? I've got to find another £7.5 million up to 2016, and it may even be more than that. We're trying to do that by working in collaboration with Bedfordshire and Hertfordshire. We've already got a partnership agreement with them. I've been talking to Suffolk, I've been talking to Northampton as well, just so we can spread the costs and reduce some of the expenditure we have. I didn't want to go the whole hog, as was the case before the election of 4GS. That was wrong, it really was, and it wouldn't have worked in my opinion. So we're looking at perhaps contracting out on one or two things, perhaps letting one county or the other, one police force or the other, take the lead. And I have flagged this up to Cambridge County Council, I've flagged it up to Peterborough as well, because we're all in this together, and if they can provide a service cheaper than we're doing it, then we want to talk to them. So we're trying to save money in that direction, and I think that's pretty important. I did this year have to put the precept up, 1.92, and that was done with a real purpose, because I wanted, again, sustainability. The government had a plan that they would have given me 1% if I froze the whole thing, but it would have left us £500,000 short. And as all of you know who are in local government, once you've done that, it follows you, and it sort of multiplies up. And we would have been, by 2016, 1.7 million short. And I wasn't prepared to go down that particular path. For the sake of doing what I did, not only have we stabilised ourselves, but I was able to introduce 10 new police this year, and we're hoping to sort of increase that as we go along, because the other big problem we've got in Cambridgeshire is the expansion of Cambridgeshire. With more people coming in, it does mean more services, it does mean more policemen, and I've got to have regard to that. And the good news is that we've got falling crime rates right across the board. Quite a challenge to me, because they're already falling. To try and keep it that way is going to be quite difficult. But I'm delighted that, you know, Cambridgeshire is one of the safer places in this country, and that's the way we want to keep it.
Thank you, Ben. Are you happy for people to ask questions?
Of course.
Have up to half an hour or so. I mean, I know we've got other business this evening, but about half an hour, that'd be about right. I'm conscious that councillors always have questions to ask, but I'll let them.
If they make them short, I'll try and make my answers short.
To see if any members of the audience who've come here this evening, perhaps specifically to ask anything, have any questions. Mr. Tiger certainly has, I'm sure.
Would it be possible for Sir Graham to stand up so we could see from the back?
Here I am. I was looking at papers at the time, but as I'm doing it off the cuff now, I'll stand up for you.